Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I feel like this is like such a long time no see kind of thing. I needed a break. Oh my gosh. So the day you're seeing this, the February 15th, 10 days before the day you're seeing this video, February 15th, I got my second round of the coronavirus vaccine. I felt really good after the first one. I only felt a little tired, but the second one really got me. I was so sick. I felt so tired and worn down and weak and fatigued and achy and like I had chills and stuff. And quite frankly, last weekend, the way I do things because of my work schedule, I don't film on the weekdays. I only film on the weekends. So for me, I do 5 videos in a weekend and that's doable for me. But the thing is that I had no like energy. I could barely get off the couch. Like I needed that time for me and I'm really glad that I did that because now we are back. We're gonna be organizing this mess, the mess that's on my makeup desk, and we're just gonna have a good time. So yeah, I'm really excited to do this. I feel fantastic now. We are about, well, the day that you're seeing this, we are 10 days post-vaccine. I feel fantastic. Like my arm isn't sore at all. Like I feel great. Do I recommend getting the vaccine? Yes, it only lasts for a few days. But when I did get it on a Friday, I had to be done. So yeah, if you have not already, don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell, give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed, and we are gonna go ahead and organize all of this. So if you guys have not seen my ranking my eyeshadow palettes video, I'm gonna link that down below for you, but this is the aftermath, and I thought I was gonna be cleaning it up sooner than this, but yeah, this is my desk. It's incredibly messy, so we are gonna get this show on the road. We're gonna do a little bit of decluttering. I don't know how much decluttering we're going to do, to be honest, because I do go through my stuff actually kind of frequently. And I know this sounds like crazy because I know I have a lot of palettes and a lot of makeup. Like, please don't judge me. Like, the thing is that, like, I love makeup. Makeup is literally what I love to do, and I'm not trying to like rub it in your face and show you how much I have and stuff, but like I know you guys really like it. So yeah, okay, let's go ahead and get started. Over here, this is just like stuff that honestly I leave out for work and then I'm too lazy to put away. Yes, I'm that person 100%. I did want to show you, I did not get this bag, but I did an Ulta order where I got like my conditioner and like some other stuff. And I also ordered some fun stuff. I got this whole, all these samples in here for free. I got this for free. Yes, I got this for free. Perks of being a Diamond member at Ulta. I got this for half off, which I'm so excited to try. And then down here, let me just show you. Yes, I got both of these ColourPop lip sets for half off. And I got a Kylie Cosmetics palette for free. There's my dog, hello. Literally, I got the Sipping Pretty palette for free. Yes, I'm going to be trying it out on camera, like first impressions kind of thing. But like, I got these for half off and I like could not say no because like I really like these formulas and stuff. And I was originally tempted to purchase these on Black Friday when they were like kind of on sale. And I'm so glad I also bought the new Morphe foundation. This is just the Kylie Cosmetics box. I wanted to like keep that. I got a mini version of the marshmallow primer. Heard good things about that. What else did I buy? I got some like backup stuff. Like I'm running low on my foundations. I'm like restocking that. Oh, I got the ABH Iced Out Highlighter, yes. I got the Morphe Foundation Brush for free. Ooh, I got this new ColourPop blush to try out. Got a backup of my Morphe brow pencil. Got a backup of my Tarte primer. I got like some backup of my face wash. Like we're good to go. Cause like I go through my like acne face wash from CeraVe so quickly. So I always keep like a backup in there because like
I hate like waiting for shipping and stuff. So I cannot believe how many free things I got, the like low key. Like, keep an eye out for those emails from Ulta if you're a platinum or diamond member. Okay, let's go ahead, organize these palettes and get started. You hear my dog in the background. He's having a grand old time today. There he is. Okay, let's go ahead and officially get started. Okay, so like, I don't know how to organize all of these. Like, do I want to do it by brand? Do I want to do it by like, I want to work on using? Like, I don't know, because I'm always like just reaching around for whatever. So I'm just kind of thinking like I should be organizing it by what I want to use. But that's what I've done in the past, and I don't know how efficient that was. Oh gosh, I don't know how this is going to go at all. I did. Like I said, this is not a declutter video whatsoever, but I did want to declutter a couple items. So we're gonna get rid of the Love Struck palette by Profusion. Profusion has some great palettes, but this one is definitely not one of them. I also wanted to get rid of the Violet Voss Best Life palette. I got this on a boxy pop-up for super duper cheap. It was like $5. But like, I don't know. Like, I am just like not feeling it. I don't know. So we're gonna like declutter it. This Revolution like Foil Frenzy palette, I literally like, it's so pretty, but like I never use this, and it's like some of the shades are like on the verge of like drying up, and I don't know. Yeah, it was really cheap. And I'm gonna declutter two Morphe palettes. I'm gonna get rid of the 35M, which is this one, and I'm gonna get rid of the 35V as well. So yeah, of course this is not a declutter video like whatsoever. I'm not focusing on decluttering at all, but I did like go through stuff and I'm like, okay, like I could realistically get rid of these and I would not miss them. I don't know what I want to do about these. Like, ugh, I don't know. They're so bulky. Okay. But like at the same time, do I really want to keep these? I just don't know. Like, I really do like Blood Sugar. That's really good. There's some really nice shades in Blue Blood as well. Conspiracy, like, it's all right. I like the top row. That's really nice. It's just kind of random for me. I don't know why I bought into the hype. But okay, we're gonna organize them, and yeah, okay, we're just gonna get into it, I guess. I don't know how I'm gonna do this. So I just got like my larger palettes like stacked together. I'm gonna get like my medium sized palettes and like my smaller palettes, and then any kind of like long like rectangular palettes. Hopefully that works. Maybe. Thank you.
anyways, going through more eyeshadow palettes, I found more than I wanted to actually declutter. So I'm going to declutter Sol and Mar from ColourPop. I just do not, let's keep these. I'm going to declutter Essentials 2 by Violet Voss. I just don't use this, so we're gonna get rid of that. We're also gonna get rid of the Smashbox LA Cover Shot palette. I just don't use it. Same reason for all of these. The BH Cosmetics Take Me Back to Brazil Rio Edition. I don't use it. Another one here, Ciate London, the Editor Palette New England. This is nice, but like I just feel like I have other ones that I like a lot more. This one, I just, it stresses me out. I don't like it. So I'm going to get more palettes we're getting rid of. I don't know if I'm going to get rid of any more. But I did kind of organize based on shape here. So I did kind of like my longer rectangular palettes, more square palettes, medium, small, medium, large, large, and then small. So we're gonna kind of go through that way because I like to stack like bigger in the back, smaller in the front. So let's go ahead and organize. Guys, he just wants attention. Oh, yeah. He likes getting hugs. Let's go look at the camera. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Can I try and put away some makeup? Make it a little more clean in here? Yeah. How about I do that, okay? Can I do that? Can I put away makeup? Oh. Ew, but I gotta put away my makeup. It's messy in here. Oh, rascal. Low rascal. Thank you. Yes. Oh, yes. He said, don't put away makeup. Just cuddle with me. Yeah. You guys, look. Oh, whoops. You guys, look, it's all organized. All I have left are these mini palettes right here. I don't know exactly what I should do with them because before they were just in one of these drawers for this. But yeah, I'm wondering if I should just continue to do that or if I should like spread them out throughout here. I think I'm going to put some of these palettes in this basket because this one's a little empty. And then I'm gonna put the rest in here. All right, you guys, now it is time to clean up the main table, desk, vanity, whatever you want to call it. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started.
next gonna be organizing all of my samples that I just got in this most recent Ulta order. And we're just gonna kind of be organizing it like via like makeup, skincare, and then hair care, because I keep like a lot of other stuff in the bathroom. This is mainly like my makeup area. So first, I'm gonna put these two. I'm really excited to try this. I know Clinique is not cruelty-free, but like, I'm low-key excited to try this. So I just wanna like show you everything that I've like gotten, because this is like super cool. So let's first start with hair care. I got this Perfect Shine Clarifying Scalp Scrub. I don't know what brand it's from, but yeah, that's really fun. I also got, let's see, I've definitely tried this before. This is the Biolage All-in-One Coconut Infusion. It's not like my favorite, but I think I could give that to like my mom. I've also tried this Deep Clean Dry Shampoo from Redken, and I love it. We have the Pureology Hydrate Shampoo and Conditioner. This is not for me, but I definitely know who will love this. Oh, hello. I'm so excited to try this. This is the Kenra Invisible Top Coat Smoothing Humidity Resistance Spray. I am so into this. This is so cool. I also got this Virtue Restorative Treatment Mask. This I'm also like super curious. This I'm also super curious about. Like, I'm so excited. We also got Briogeo Don't Despair Repair Deep Conditioning Mask. I love this stuff. So very, very, very excited. Always with samples, like, I usually just like give them away, like if I'm not gonna use them. Most of the stuff in the hair care though, I am for sure going to use. For fragrance, I only got a couple. I don't usually use a whole lot of like fragrance stuff, but I got the Clinique My Happy Cookies and Kisses. I also got the Givenchy Irresistible, and then the Donna Karan Cashmere Mist. So fun. This is a towelette. Okay, I don't know how much I'm gonna use that towelette, but I will give it to somebody who will use it. For skincare, oh my gosh. So first off, IT Confidence in a Cream, yes. I also got this Acure Brightening Cleansing Gel, very interesting. The Murad Hydration Intense Recovery Cream, this looks super duper cool. Sorry, I'm trying to keep it in the frame. Then I got the Kiehl's Clearly Corrective Dark Spot Solution. Again, very excited to try this. I should kick it out of the little paper thing though, just to like save room in my bathroom. But yeah, I'm really excited to try that as well. This was like a deluxe free sample. It's the Clinique Moisture Surge Auto Replenishing Hydrator. So it's just like a moisturizer. Yeah, this did not come in the box, but I don't know, this looks interesting. Maybe I'll give it a go. Like, it looks like a really light like gel moisturizer almost, so screw it, I'm gonna give it a try because this looks really cool. I have no idea what this is. I'm gonna have to Google it, but this is the Shiseido Ultimmune Power Infusing Concentrate. What is this? Like, I know it's skincare because like I unscrewed it and it looks like skincare. I'm gonna have to do again some Google searching, but interesting. We got the Tula Cult Classic Purifying Face Cleanser. Clarins Total Eye Lift. I've never really used anything from Clarins. I'm guessing that this is just like an eye cream of some sort, but yeah, that'll be interesting to try. This is the La Roche-Posay face moisturizer with double repair face moisturizer with SPF 30. I've never tried this brand, and I'm really excited to. We got some Advanced Night Repair from Estee Lauder. Oh, this is this stuff. Yes. Okay, I've heard people talking about this, like, always, and I've never, like, used it. So let's give that a go. The Mario Badescu Hyaluronic Dew Cream. I don't know if I'll use this, but a Sunday Riley CEO 15% Vitamin C Serum. Super cool. I'm really excited to try this. This is the Peter Thomas Roth Water Drench Hyaluronic Cloud Hydrating Eye Gel.
I got some Dynamic Skin Recovery from Dermalogica. That'll be nice. And then the Vichy Life Active Peptide C. I don't know what this is. Hydrates and plumps. Is this like a serum? This looks like a serum. Wait, what? What the heck? You guys, what is this? This is like a glass vial, and then it came with this. Like, we're gonna need some directions, but let's figure this out. That's weird, but like, I'm curious. Lastly, for makeup here, these two things I did not get with this whole thing. Like I said, I paid half off for this mini ABH mascara, and then I got this for free as part of a platinum diamond like free gift, but this is a full size of the Cover FX monochromatic lip color. This is in the shade Warm Honey as well. Very excited to try that out, but let's look at the stuff that actually came in the kit. Baby of the Always On liquid lipstick from Smashbox in the shade Audition. I have the Milani highly rated mascara. The Clinique Moisture Surge Lip Hydrator. I feel like this is makeup. Like this is something I would keep in here. Lip Replenishing Hydrator. We're gonna try that out. So we'll keep that in here. We got another mini of the Becca like water powder. I really like this stuff. Got a mini of the Beauty Blender Solid Soap. You got the Pure No Filter Blurring Photography Primer. Very cool. And then I also got Lancôme Definicils Mascara. This shocked me. This is a full size, you guys. This is the MAC Powder Kiss Lipstick in the shade. Work, work, work. And okay, I've never tried the Powder Kiss lipsticks. Like I said, MAC is not cruelty free, so I normally don't use a whole lot of MAC. But like, this is so pretty. It's like, have to use it, right? I should definitely just try this out just for the heck of it, right? All right, let's organize this stuff and then we should be finished up. All right, you guys, this is the finished look. Don't mind like the makeup. I should have removed this before. And don't mind that makeup wipe. I'm in the middle of filming swatches. But oh my gosh, you guys, it's all organized. Hallelujah. Okay, so that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed. If you have not already, don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell, give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed. And I will see you tomorrow for another video. Bye.